Hello everyone, my name is John. Today, I will tell you how to set up uploading data from one service to another through the ApiX-Drive system. This is necessary in order to automatically transfer, for example, new leads from Facebook to Google Sheets by creating new lines there, or to SMS and email mailing services in order to further interact with these contacts, or in the CRM system, creating new lead or transaction entities based on data from Facebook. Now let's move on to the setup. First, you need to create a new connection. Then you need to choose one of the 200 ready-made integrations. You can select the required system by finding it in this list. Or use categories: CRM systems, chatbots, messengers, CMS systems, marketplaces, Google services. In this case, we are interested in the Facebook system. Now you need to select an action. If we want to receive new leads, we select the action Get Leads New. At this stage, we need to connect the Facebook account to the ApiX-Drive service. In this window, you must specify the login and password of your personal Facebook account. Now let's move on to advanced settings. At this stage, you see the advertising pages to which you have access. The advertising pages for which you want to receive leads must be ticked. I recommend marking all advertising pages at once at this stage in order to be able to work with them in the future. If you get a new advertising page after connecting your Facebook account to ApiX-Drive, you will need to repeat the connection via incognito in the browser, and at this stage check the new advertising page. Leave all checkboxes enabled. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. At this stage, you need to select an advertising page and forms for which you want to receive new leads. If you want to receive leads for all advertising forms at once, leave yes, connect all current and new forms. If you want to receive leads on some specific forms, select no, select forms individually and tick the necessary forms. At this stage, you can set up a data filter. In this case, there is no need for this, so just click continue. At this stage, you see an example of one of your leads. If there is no data at this stage or ApiX-Drive test data is displayed, you need to wait for a real lead or generate a test lead through Facebook Business Messenger. After you do this, click Load Test Data from Facebook, and when the lead appears at this stage, click Next. On this, the Facebook data source setup has been successfully completed. Now you need to move on to setting up data reception. As a data receiving system, you can choose one of 200 ready-made services, also selecting it from the list, or use the categories: CRM systems, chatbots, messengers, CMS systems, email services, SMS services, or Google services. In this case, we need to select Google Sheets. At this stage, we need to choose an action. We want to create a new row in Google Sheets with each new lead, so we select the Add Row action. At this stage, you need to connect your Google Sheets account to the ApiX-Drive system. In this window, specify the username and password of your personal Google account. At this stage, it is necessary, of course, to check all the checkboxes for access. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. At this stage, you must specify the file and sheet to which new data from Facebook will be added. If you have the names of the columns in the table in the first line, then it will be pulled up in brackets opposite each of them. In these columns, you can assign variables from Facebook, In order to do this, click in the field and select a variable from the drop-down list. Note that you can use not only variables, but also write values manually. When all the required fields are filled, click Continue. At this point, you see an example of the data that will be sent to Google Sheets as new rows for each new lead from Facebook. If something does not suit you, click Edit and go back a step. In order to check the correctness of the settings, click Send Test Data to Google Sheets. After successful submission, go to Google Sheets and check the result. If everything suits you, return to the ApiX-Drive service and continue setting up. This completes the setup for receiving Google Sheets data successfully. Now you need to enable auto update. But if we want to transfer leads from Facebook, except for Google Sheets, to another service in parallel, then we need to add one more data reception and configure it separately. As a system, we can choose, for example, the Mailchimp email service. As an action, select Add Contacts. At this stage, we need to connect the Mailchimp account to the ApiX-Drive system. For this, we need to specify an API key. To get it, go to your personal account Mailchimp. Then go to Profile Settings. Now go to the Extras API Keys section. If you have not yet created an API key, you can do this by clicking on the Create a Key button. I will use the already created API key. Check that the key status is enabled. After you have copied the API key, paste it into the corresponding field in the ApiX-Drive system. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. At this stage, you need to select a list to which new contacts will be added with each new lead from Facebook. You now see the Mailchimp fields for creating a new contact. You also assign variables from Facebook to these fields. When all the required fields are filled, click Continue. At this point, you see an example of the data that will be sent to Mailchimp as new contacts for each new lead from Facebook. If something does not suit you, click Edit and go back a step. In order to check the correctness of the settings, click Send Test Data to Mailchimp. After successful sending, go to Mailchimp and check the result. If everything suits you, return to the ApiX-Drive service and continue setting up. On this setup of another data ingestion, Mailchimp completed successfully. Now, when a new lead from Facebook appears, a new line will be created in Google Sheets, and a new contact will be added to Mailchimp. If we want to add one more data reception, we do this. As a system for receiving data, we select, for example, the CRM system Zoho. Now you need to select an action. Create lead. At this stage, you need to connect your Zoho CRM account to the ApiX-Drive system. In this window, you must specify the login and password of your Zoho personal account. At this point, you need to give ApiX-Drive permission to work with your Zoho account. When the connected login is displayed in the list, select it. Now you see the Zoho CRM fields. To create a new lead, you can assign variables from Facebook to these fields. You can also use not only variables, but also write values manually. When all the required fields are filled, click Continue. At this point, you see an example of the data that will be sent to Zoho CRM as new leads for each new lead from Facebook. If something does not suit you, click Edit and go back a step. In order to check the correctness of the settings, click Send Test Data to Zoho CRM. After successful submission, go to Zoho and check the result. If everything suits you, return to the ApiX-Drive service and continue setting up. At this point, we've set up another Zoho CRM data ingestion. With each new lead, data will be transferred to Google Sheets as new lines, to Mailchimp as new contacts, and to Zoho CRM as new leads. Now you can enable auto-update. Now we select the communication interval, for example, once every 5 minutes. That's all. I wish you successful integration settings and good luck.